All right, we're back. Sorry about the drop. My streaming software just crashed on us here. We had to restart it, and it actually ended the last link for us. So we'll use this for now. Sorry about that once again. I know there's a couple of you guys that are here watching, but we're back up. We're running. So hopefully it doesn't drop out again.
Just about to get underway with the farmers and sandbag carry. So we've kind of got the split screen going, so the start finish lines, so the farmer's handles are currently sitting at the start line. Got to carry those all the way to the end to where the sandbags are. Implements have to completely cross the line, then pick up the sandbag and run back the other way. Of course, as quickly as humanly possible. So we're probably another couple minutes away from kicking off, but shouldn't be too long now. To see Jocelyn giving kind of the last minute instruction and rules to all the athletes.
Athletes.
Make sure that there's no make sure there's no confusion on exactly where the implements have to end.
That's awesome.
Isn't that awesome?
That is awesome, yeah.
I'm so excited for her.
That's good.
Anyways, that's my story today.
There you go.
Excuse me, sorry.
You're completely invisible to the internet at this point. Yeah. Completely invisible. Call me the magic man. 1 minute I'm here, the next I'm not. I liked your deadlift post from yesterday. It's good. For now. Yeah. Yeah. Just the necessary amount.
Welcome back to those of you that have switched over. Unfortunately, my live stream software on the computer just decided to end itself and delete the ability for us to continue streaming. So,
all right, athletes ready, judges ready. 3, 2, 1, go!
Guess we should figure out who's going here.
Those are quite the farmer's handles.
I want to say this is
Rorick, last name.
Yeah, so this must be Jason. This must be our novice men, Jason Rorick. And that over there in the far side, Jaslyn, that's correct. Yeah, Jaslyn. Jaslyn and Jason.
Again, with the alliteration. Jason got those farmers all the way across the line. He's just going to pop back in the screen. There he goes. And away he goes.
little bit of a fall there, but he's going to get back up.
Last couple feet, he's just got to pick that back
yeah,
up.
Yeah, less than a foot away.
The handles on those farmer's implements are fairly thick, so with smaller hands, it's definitely pretty tough. Give him a round of applause.
Up next, we should have Muhammad. Muhammad and Virginia. I like the Celtic music in the background. I don't know if the stream can hear it or not, but.
Heavy bass Celtic music really fits in with all the kilts that we have floating around here today.
Absolutely.
Not sure if Doug inspired everyone, but of course, Gary with a last name like McDonald, you'd think there's probably some kilts somewhere in his family.
Probably.
Kilt looks a little long, but it's actually just his inseam is very short.
Got Mohammed starting on the other side. You can just see him just off the camera.
Judges are ready. Three.
They're going opposite directions. This is now a head-to-head.
Mohammed really quick with those farmers. All the way across the line of the implement.
Drops the sandbag.
A bobble, but that's okay. Get a quick hit.
Keep going, keep going. Nice stop.
Over the line for both. That really shows the amount of time that gets taken if you end up dropping an implement and have to re-pick it.
Absolutely.
Right? One person with a slower pace that's able to keep the implement up and going the entire time will set a better time than if you have to re-pick multiple times in one run.
100%. Nice thing about being in a gym is the surface is perfectly flat. We don't have any competitive advantage if we are running this in a parking lot.
There's not a lane of preference for sure.
No, yeah. Up next we got Lynn. You can see her on your right portion of the screen. And we have Jordan Rorick on the left-hand side of your screen, starting both with the farmer handles.
Late Lauzon, last name.
Oh yes, Jordan Lauzon, sorry. There's two Jordans. I was looking at the one below.
That's why we're a team, buddy.
Yeah.
All right, athletes, are you ready? Judges, are you ready? 3, 2, 1, go!
Both athletes off to a good start.
Jordan all the way across the line just dumps those handles. Little war cry as he runs with that sandbag.
He flies over the edge there. Still Lynn working on her lane there.
Just gets that implement. It's got to be the full implement across the line. Oh, that sandbag really quick. That's great.
That's a good catch up for her.
Yeah, for sure.
A little bit of a slow run with the handles, but as soon as she got to that bag, she made up some serious time.
Yeah.
Up next, we're going to have the other Jordan in the novice class, Jordan Rorick. And in the women's lane, we're going to have Leanna. Big shout out to all the volunteers here today. You can see Olivia helping out with the women's lane. We got Mackenzie, a couple others. I don't actually quite know all of these people's names, but got a good crew of volunteers here today to make this competition go round.
Once again, so great to be able to see them from any angle because they're in bright orange.
Yes, exactly.
Like cute little pylons. Some big pylons.
Last minute instruction from one of the Alberta representatives saying stop throwing the handles.
Judges ready. 3, 2, 1, go!
Jordan Rorick, quick pick with the handles, moving fast. He watched the other Jordan go really fast. Gets it over the line, onto the sandbag. He's got to sprint with that sandbag. and it's over.
Let's go. Good pick of that sandbag, and she's gone.
Leanna moving quite well with that sandbag. Up next in the women's lane, we're going to have Sapphire from the novice women and Isaiah from the novice men's side.
Once again, handles and everything, all the implements, exactly how the athletes want them prior to their start.
Athlete, ready.
Sapphire being told, don't cross the line. Not until we're ready again.
3, 2, 1, go!
Good pace for the farmers, for Sapphire, as well as Isaiah. Isaiah moving quick, running down there with that sandbag.
Sapphire gets that bag clean. All the ladies in that lane seem to be really quick with that sandbag as soon as they can get to it. So it's just a matter of minimizing the damage on the time for your farmers.
Absolutely. Up next, we got Paula in the women's lane and Jarrett in the men's lane.
Stop by United Strength on my way home for their half-price drop-in and free energy drink.
It's only 12 till 5, though.
All right,
yeah, I gotta go.
Judges ready. 3, 2, 1, go!
Good pick, nice pace.
Jarrett doing really well there. Paula having a great grip in this event.
Paula very, very strong, nice and steady. We'll see how she does. Gets that bag up. There we go.
Go.
Really good time from both athletes. For that.
I'm going to say Paula probably has taken first place here for the novice women. Judging by how fast her farmers went there,
yeah.
She definitely has put herself in a good position for points here. Up next, we got Ashley. Didn't do as well in the stone lift as she did in the other couple events. She's now place fifth in the stone press. And then we also have Adam in the men's lane.
And with the amount of athletes that they have in that division, it's going to be interesting to see how all the points shake out, because we haven't had one competitor that's really dominated from start to finish.
Yeah,
so
no.
There'll be a lot of point shuffling going on throughout the day.
Absolutely.
Okay, athletes ready.
Ashley's looking dialed in to start.
3, 2, 1, go!
Go command.
Good pick. Wow, Ashley being one of the shorter competitors, she's just barely clearing the ground with those handles.
Yeah, if she takes too far of a step, she's going to bump off the ground. Adam moving really fast and finishing quite quick. Ashley going for a run.
And again, really, really quick with the sandbag. Just got to get the minimize the damage with the farmers and make up time with that sandbag.
Absolutely.
Really solid run for both. I'm going home tonight, so.
Oh, okay.
I still have to train tomorrow. It's going to be super late. We got to do events tomorrow.
Oh.
These
jabs are going to mail on in Kelowna.
Nice, nice.
3, 2,
up next, here
one,
we got
go.
Drew, I believe, Drew Hayes. Yep.
Look up, Natalie, look up.
Natalie pushing really hard with those.
Get a good transition with that sandbag, and she's going to put up a really good time if she can get down the track here.
A little bit of a delay picking it up for Natalie.
Yeah, she struggled a little bit just getting that up into her lap. But again, it's going to be very interesting to see how all these times play out.
Absolutely.
Having two different implements where you have that transition between can be a huge equalizer, because your run time can actually be very quick, but if your transition is really slow, you lose a lot of speed there.
Yes. Next in the women's lane, we got Nicole Kent. And in the men's lane, we got Colton. Both athletes are right at their starting points. Another, Nicole is actually quite short as well, so his pick isn't very hard, very high for her. Or it is high for her.
3, 2, 1, go!
Yeah, very similar to Ashley in the fact that you could just barely see her shoes underneath those handles.
Yeah, no kidding.
A very gentle set down.
Very high pick. Yeah.
Both athletes extremely fast in the bag. Really good run. I think Nicole put on a very good time for that. Again, that class is going to be, it'll be interesting to see how it all shakes out, just timing-wise.
Up next in the men's lane, we got Mike. And in the women's lane, we got Carolyn. There's only one athlete that didn't go all the way. Everybody else has completed the event. Comes down to who runs faster. Carolyn with a good pace. Gets over the line.
Yeah, she can get this bag clean. There we go. Yeah, it's really gonna come down to how fast they can go.
100%. I think once we start getting into the higher weight classes, it's gonna be a little bit different. But for the most part, here it comes down to speed in these novice and lightweight classes. And the last up for the women is Mandy. Mandy's been doing really well, actually. She's been top three, top four the entire competition.
Yeah, and with the shuffling of everybody else, as far as points per event go, it's she might be in a very, very solid position.
All right.
Absolutely.
Athletes ready.
We got Michael Klassen over in the men's lane
here.
3, 2, 1,
go!
I believe actually Michael and Mandy are training partners.
Okay. Michael had a really good run there. Quick clean on the bag, and he is off.
Losing his grip a little bit there at the end, but he finished strong, and so does Mandy. Flying over, almost running into the crowd. That is it for the novice women. We're going to have a little bit of a weight change for the novice women's farmer's carries, I believe. And we got Braden Rupert for the novice men coming up in the men's lane.
Starting to get up into our top five athletes in each weight class.
Absolutely. Up next and up last, we have Clifford for the men's lane and Jen Sager for the women's lane.
Not sure if you guys caught that on camera, but that was Larson Hare doing, call it a circus dumbbell press with a sandbag with 100 pounds.
Tight one between Braden and Michael. They're both really fast there. Let's see if Clifford can put up the same performance.
I mentioned that earlier. I think this is going to be a really hard class.
Three, two, one, go!
That week, or that division is going to be very, very competitive all the way through. Clifford really quick there as well. That's war cry.
Really fast for both athletes.
Absolutely.
That's going to be a tight one. The top three novice men that just went, the last three, they are very they're neck and neck with their times.
We're going to have a weight change in lane one.
Lane one's going up in weight. I believe we're going to be jumping to the U80s, if I'm not mistaken.
Martin up next on the far lane.
Yep, last women's masters to go. She's been actually holding her own this entire competition. She's been going last every time, so I'm not 100% sure right now, but I think this is pretty close to a sweep for her.
Yeah, I would think it would be very close if not already secured as one. And then who do we got coming up here on this close lane?
No, not a sweep for Allie. Allie placed second in the truck pole, or in the bus pole, but the other two events she placed first in, so.
Sitting first overall for that Masters group.
All right, athletes ready, judges ready.
Got
three,
Luke.
Two, one, go!
Luke in the men's lane here.
Let's go, Allie.
Oh, a little bit of a wobble there for Luke.
A little bit of a misgrab for Allie.
Squeeze those hands. Move, move, move.
Luke trying to get up that 200-pound sandbag.
That's it, all the way.
A little bit of a mishap. You guys missed it on camera, but he just fell down.
It's the downside of getting that rush of I need to make up time, right? You start to make mistakes of too big a step.
Yeah, feet were going a little too fast for the head. So I don't know what happened here, but Moses isn't going for the U80s. Oh, sorry, never mind. Moses is going for the U80s. Just was looking the wrong direction.
This alternating implement thing.
Yeah, I know. One of the hardest events to plan in a strongman competition is a multi-implement event. We're looking at it right now for K-Days, trying to decide what implements we're using for the wheelbarrow load. We're going to have like 15 different implements. There's so many, there's whatever, we have six weight classes, right?
Right.
Try to overlap some of them, like the heaviest for the men is going to, or the lightest for the men is going to be the heaviest for the women, sort of thing. But
don't give me too much information. I'm going in there.
Don't you worry, I'm not giving you any.
Alright.
We've got Todd Yuditsky.
Judges ready. 3, 2, 1, go!
Todd with a really good pace.
Let's go!
Todd onto the sandbag, both athletes to the sandbag. Moses moving really well with that sandbag. I don't know, that's going to be a close one too because Moses dropped the farmer's holder quite a few times.
Yeah, having to re-grip those two times really, really kills your time.
Absolutely. So we're moving probably to the U90s. A little bit. Yeah. Got Ian lining up for the men here, so we're up into the U90s.
And Josh Glordy lining up. Oh, wait, no, Shea O'Brien.
Has incredible grip strength.
Come on, Shane. Ian is flying with that bag.
He had to make up some points. His overhead kind of threw him.
Let's go, Shane.
Shane was a little hesitant coming off the line with that bag, but made up some time in the middle for sure.
I think Ian's going to be getting a penalty. He dropped the farmer's carries before the line.
If that's the case, he's going to end up with a no time on that second half.
Or are they just going to give him a five-second penalty? Or I don't know what the...
Because they did go over the fact, in the athletes meeting, they went over the fact that the entire implement has to come across the line.
Oh, okay.
Not roll across. It has to be picked up and brought across the line.
Interesting
to see what comes of that. Maybe a judge's call.
Golden, what's happening with, is this going to be a time penalty? 5 second penalty. So we just got word from, yeah. Colton just, we reached out to Colton. Colton said that Ian will be getting a 5 second penalty for not crossing the line fully, so.
Judges ready. 3, 2, 1, go!
Shandy in the men's lane, Jacqueline in the women's lane.
Come on, Shan. You got it, buddy. Keep going, come on.
Let's go all the way.
Both athletes able to keep that the whole way across. Shandy deciding to drop the belt. Really good pace on both of those ends.
We're flying through this event. It's going quite quick. Considering it's only two lanes, it's moving very smooth here.
Yeah.
Got Larson helping reset some of the implements now. You can tell some of the athletes are starting to get worn down.
That's another one of the reasons why it takes so many volunteers. You know, every time an athlete does an implement, there's a volunteer that has to move that same implement, right?
Absolutely.
Unless you're Colton, in which case the heaviest implement you're moving is a stopwatch.
Give him a break, his back hurts.
Yeah. Had a big deadlift day yesterday. So we were told.
Oh, I was here. I watched it. It happened. I think he pulled 635 for 5 reps. Really good deadlift. What he needs to work on is what he was saying his coach is working on with him is getting his deadlift up. That might be able to get him in some pretty big shows if he gets that up.
Yeah, so far in his pro career, he's already been in some pretty good shows to date.
Absolutely.
And if he can bring that deadlift up, I'm sure he'll have even more international exposure. So
yes, exactly.
It's always great. Always nice to see people from Western Canada getting a little more attention.
Well, actually, fun fact too, Colton's first competition was my first competition that I ran.
Oh, really?
So back here at Evolve North, before they laid the turf, we had something called Yoke Fest, and Colton placed second against Leif Wells, who's a well-known well-known strongman. Yeah. So,
we're
just talking about your debut back in 2018. Yeah. Jessica Petrick in the women's lane, and Serhi in the men's lane.
3, 2, 1, go!
A little bit heavy for Serhi. He's unable to break the ground.
That's it, Jess.
Jess with a good pace.
Yeah, 90. What are they at for weight? 200 and change per hand?
Somewhere around there, yeah. I think he was having a grip issue here. He was trying to stick his thumb in the implement, I saw.
Well, I noticed Ian did the same thing, kind of went thumb over the end of the implement. So.
Oh, interesting.
I'm not sure if that's just how they're comfortable with it or if that's something that they do on a regular basis. I know when I do farmers, that is not where I put my thumb.
No, I mean, well, especially since there's basically a hole sitting in there, that's potentially a little dangerous. Your thumb goes in there and it doesn't come out, but you let go of the implement. Like, you're asking for
A 200-pound bowling ball, get rid of your thumb pretty quick.
Yeah, exactly.
Who needs a thumb anyway? You got two.
Well, this now switches it up since we had a no finish for Serhii. Both athletes will be starting and finishing at the same line. We've got Evan Jaworski in the men's lane and Shannon McLean in the women's lane.
Athletes ready. Judges ready. 3, 2, 1, go!
Good start for both athletes. Shannon dropped the implement.
A little tentative getting it away from her feet.
Oh, Evan with the shoulder. Look at this man go.
Well over the line for Evan. You guys probably didn't even see him on the camera. That's how fast he was going.
The flash.
Come on, Shannon. Come on, everybody. Let's give a hot round of applause for Shannon. We're going to get her again.
Shannon just off of the screen here. Struggling to repick the farmer's carries here.
That's it, Shannon. Give her another try.
Those handles with the thicker handle makes it very difficult if you have smaller hands.
Try to get as far as you can. That's it, one more.
Just about to come back on the camera here.
You can just see it pulling out of her fingers as she picks it
up.
Shannon finished just about where you could see Olivia, who's in the orange short there, or orange shirt there, standing kind of in the middle of the competition area. So I would give her guess it's about 20 feet, 25 feet. I think the halfway mark, I think it's a 50-foot run. So I want to say this
probably
is
20 feet.
25, 20 feet, yeah.
Local celebrity Martin Blair coming up and again herding some cats, getting everybody in place.
He's got to make sure he's got the right camera angle for the gram.
Absolutely. Multiple camera angles.
Yes. Just measuring Shannon's farmer's walk length.
What's the last event?
Keg over bar.
Keg over bar.
Got Melissa for the U82 lane. And I believe we are into...
I think it would be
105s again. Yeah, the 105s and Masters. So Avery Toon is up first, and then Martin comes after him.
Okay. Both athletes at the start line, so throw a little confusion into who I'm
cheering. Are athletes ready? Judges ready. 3, 2, 1, go!
Melissa off to a good start there. Dropped it just out of camera view, and she's just about to start getting into the camera view again.
Good steady pace. Again, if you can maintain a solid pace, it's better than dropping multiple times. Avery having a hard time with that initial pick. Melissa onto that bag. She's got it up high. All the way back with it.
And a good finish for Melissa. That's the win she needs.
Avery just doesn't quite have it in the bag today. Gonna try and give it a little bit of a go.
He needs to hear us now.
There he goes. That's better than a zero. Every inch counts.
lost his grip there, but like you said, it's better than a zero.
Yeah, you gotta get a foot across the start line. It's better than not being able to pick it.
Absolutely. Next, we have Tierney Sinclair in the women's lane, and like you said, local celebrity, Martin Blair in the men's lane.
Get that quick measurement for Avery's run, and everything reset for Martin.
Both athletes are going to be starting with their farmer's handles on the left hand of your screen there. We have Timish Horby. Timish Horby, and I believe he's just finished off with Tierney. We've got Kendra left. Kendra should be going here pretty quick. And then we'll be moving over to the big boys. The wear and tear from the volunteers, they do.
Yeah, even the judges look like they're doing a full thing.
Interesting, I think I've seen most people, the way Kendra's setting up, I've seen most people have the implement turn the handles from the board, right? Kendra's doing makes more sense, to be honest.
I haven't used handles like that, so I couldn't really call it. To me, like, in my mind, it makes more sense to have it in the handle her way.
Right.
On the open end towards your pinky.
Yeah, you see Timish here has the handles facing the other way, too. A little bit of a setback for him. He dropped it, and the handle got away from him, so just off screen there, he's dropped it. About to enter onto your screen there. Almost at the finish line. All right, I think we might be back now. Thank you for letting us know, Adam. We were commentating the entire time, but all that went to waste, so thank you for letting us know, though.
Staggered start and finish again.
Yeah.
Just how things went with that last run.
Yeah, sorry about that, guys. Once again, this is one day prepared for this live stream. There was a professional live streamer that was in place, but unfortunately, due to a family emergency, he wasn't able to make it here today. So the equipment is by far no means close to the amount of equipment and investment that Mehmet has put into his equipment. But we're making do with what we got. Up next, it looks like we have, in the 105 class, we have Andrew. And in the heavyweight class now that we're into opens, Dave Holmescourt will be the first one up for the heavyweight men.
You know, I appreciate that Dave wore purple shorts. It makes it a lot easier to pick him out in the crowd.
Exactly, yeah. A lot of people have bright colors out here today.
It's a pink versus purple run. Not sure what our DJ is doing over there, but Drops of Jupiter, not exactly the most enthusiastic song for Strongman.
I think he just let it go on autoplay and he forgot. Oh, he's walking back to it now.
Oh, it's... I even made the comment about it. Yeah, right? Yeah,
you're on
too.
The seafood diet, Colton. You have seafood and you eat it.
Man, I'd be at a special event every day.
Invite me, please.
Invite. 3, 2, 1, go!
Andrew and Dave, both at the starting line still.
Dave gives it one quick shot, says, doesn't think it's there. Andrew having a hard time breaking the ground with it. Getting a couple tips from Colton. Colton's got a really good grip too, so that helps. Take a step.
Looks like Dave.
I think Dave's gonna call it there. Gave it a couple good attempts. It's not in the bag for him today.
Andrew's getting every inch that he can, squeezing it all out.
Come on, let's share it on, folks. Every inch counts here.
These handles, just with the design of them, it kind of rolls away from you, gets away from you really quickly if you don't hold on to it completely.
Yeah, exactly. So he finishes just there. He waved it off where you see Colton's shoulder on the camera screen there. Get a quick measurement out.
Down on the far side.
Dave over here on the near side.
Coming into view. Getting a lot of encouragement from the crowd here. Coaches yelling. Trying to get every last step they can out of their athletes.
I'm not 100% sure why it keeps doing that. Strange that it did that again. If you missed it, we got Kevin.
Dave Holt.
Trevor and...
Dave Holt and Trevor on the far side.
Right. No. Kevin Holt.
Oh, Kevin Holt.
And Trevor Kulkatsky.
There we go.
Yeah, there we go. Looks like both of them didn't quite make it to the end with their implement, so measurements are going to be done. I don't know why the... audio keeps cutting out like that. It's a little strange.
Too much sweet voice for one broadcast.
I guess so.
The internet's not ready for it.
Should be
hopefully get our implements reset for another round. Yeah. Yeah, those handles are fairly thick.
Athletes ready. Judges ready. 3, 2, 1, go!
Looks like you're getting blamed. Brett says that it's your fault that the microphone keeps acting up.
That's fair. I'll take that blame. I was informed that Rowan has fractured thumb. You can see the tape on his right hand.
Good move for Steven.
Steve Benson.
Steve Benson, yeah.
Good time for him for sure. Rolling with a bum thumb would be pretty tough to be doing, Farmers. Quick reset of the handles.
Yellow's a 50. So do 180.
Got a furious amount of activity here trying to make sure that the sound gets a little better for you guys. Again, we're doing our best.
Those are pounds.
I can hear it coming through. I can hear it coming through on the speakers here. Check 1, 2. Check 1, 2. Oh, unless that's coming through the headphones, sorry. All right, up next.
That's Tyson on the far side. Tebow. Justin Tebow?
Yeah, Justin.
Athletes ready. Judges ready. 3, 2, 1, go!
I don't know if Justin just dropped it on his foot or not.
Yeah, that didn't look great. A as I said, a lot of guys are having a hard time with the handles rolling forward on them.
That's
it
true.
It puts you in a really bad spot when it comes down. Tyson trying to squeeze every inch he can out of this. Drop those right in front of our table here, so just off camera, but put in all the work to get every last inch you could out of that.
Looks like our medic is gonna take Justin off and just double check his foot and see if it's broken.
You can see him there on the right-hand side of the screen, making sure everything's okay. Of course, it's always tough to analyze the amount of pain you're in when you've got that much adrenaline running through your body as well.
Absolutely. So up next, we have James Anderson as a Masters.
Master James.
Master James.
Set after we get the handles back there. Make sure everybody's ready to go.
So we got James Anderson and Alex Clipper.
This will be another tough one for James. Doing back-to-back farmers is tough.
Yeah, luckily he's second last for this event in the open side.
Grip is definitely not one of those things that comes back right away. It's very taxing.
Judges, absolutely.
Ready. 3, 2, 1, go!
Oh, it's a little bit of a struggle for James, but he's got the momentum going. Holding his breath. I don't think he's breathed once here.
Just head down. Oh, geez, that's too bad. He could have got that another 2 feet.
What happened?
I think he's going more on the strategic side of things with that one as well.
Come on, Alex.
Alex really trying to gain every last inch he can here.
Still going.
Gotta be close to time.
Is it about I would say 15 feet? 15 out of the 50 feet? We're gonna get a quick measurement out for both these athletes.
Ryan Vance with his single track mind, just taking the tape all the way back.
Yeah, instead of taping from this end to that. It's okay. Strong man, not smart man in most circumstances.
Strong backs and weak minds usually go hand in hand.
Almost done this event here, folks. Got five more in the open. Two more in the U-105 lightweights. Brandon Jeffrey getting ready to go here. He's put on a real good performance considering he hasn't really competed over the last couple years.
Yeah, he was really strong in the overhead press.
Yeah. I think we have three lanes of yoke over bar, so it should be a pretty fast event.
Keg over bar.
Keg over bar, sorry.
Yoke over bar would be impressive.
Yoke over bar, I said, wow.
I would pay to see that, actually.
And just off to the corner of your screen, getting that up real nice and fast. You can see his grip and his left hand starting to give out, but he's really squeezing.
Dan Hagen just dropped it there, just off camera.
Another potentially foot injury just off of camera there.
Again, I think Dan's recent knee injury really makes him very tentative on that knee.
Let's go.
Trying to get those handles back in close.
30 seconds, walk that in.
Just about to see Dan again. He's in the blind spot. Dan just finishing in the blind spot, probably just real close to the edge of that camera view there. I'd say he's got a good 30 feet, 35 feet on that run.
Probably close to 35, somewhere in there. Get an official measurement, of course.
Last up for the lightweight men is Ty Andrew, who's been doing quite well for himself. He's placed nearly first place almost every event so far. The only event he didn't place first in was the bus pull. James Anderson beat him on that, but he's placed first in every other event, so looking like he has a good point advantage here going into event number 5 after this event. So Ty Andrew in the lightweight man. Sorry, we're fumbling words here. The U105s, and we got Ryan Hartman, I believe this is.
That is, yeah.
In the far lane here. Ty Andrew just getting his bag set up properly for his run.
Just doesn't want to run into it with the farmer's handles as he comes across.
I think he's also positioning it so that it's an easy pick. You're going to watch him push it down. You can't see it on the camera, but he's going to push it down on the side that it's slightly leaning on.
Athletes ready. Judges ready. 3, 2, 1.
Super strong for Ty. This is 100% putting him in first.
Come on, Ryan.
Another event win secured probably for Ty. I don't think we've seen anybody finish the sandbag.
Come on, Ryan. That's it. Squeeze it.
Long run for
Hartman.
For Hartman, yeah.
Come on, buddy.
You can tell he wants it. Dig it in.
Just in the blind spot here. Coming through the blind spot. He's just on the edge, right by Larson.
He's got to be at the 40-foot mark.
Yeah, if not more, maybe 45. Between 40 and 45 for sure. Three more to go in the heavyweight men division. We got Riley up next, James Anderson on deck, and Ben Borger, the last one to come up. Yeah, I can do that. Yeah, he can name the stream. Yeah. And I'll take your laptop home whenever I see you next. Yeah. Sure. Is it password in here at all? Okay. Up next,
Riley Whiteknife.
Riley Whiteknife. The other lane is completely done. We got three athletes left. I'll be right back.
All right. Ready.
Riley getting settled in.
Judges ready. 3, 2, 1.
Again, just having those handles spin around on you and having to readjust. Really strong on those handles. Crowd really getting behind Riley, wanting to get that bag up. He stopped right in front of us again, so right about that, call it 15, maybe 20 feet. Get a quick reset on the handles. Just out of screen there on the right side. So you can see Trevor get the sandbag ready on the left side, getting it just how he wants it. Trevor obviously did his heavyweight masters run before this already, so not sure how well his grip has recovered in the short amount of time. Hopefully he can put on a good run for this one.
Judges ready. 3, 2, 1, go!
There's James Anderson, sorry.
That's up.
Consider that every athlete that's in this does this one day event and is taxed, you know, completely spent, and he's doing essentially two full runs of everything. So, you know, it's pretty impressive that he's even moving this at this point at the end of a long day. James just going to call it there.
1 second, James Anderson.
last competitor in our heavyweight division, just off to the right of the right screen, Big Ben Borger. Get a quick measurement there for James's run, and then get those implements reset. Ryan and Larson just making sure that the implements are all secured. Big Ben looks like he's ready to go. Really solid pick from Ben. Keeping that weight right beside him, taking those smaller steps. But the design of these handles is very similar to a Dinny walk because it wants to roll out in front of you. Got about another 10 or 12 feet there for Ben to get through this, get onto that sandbag. Sandbags, no joke. Push it on your diaphragm the entire time. Get an official measurement on Ben's run there with that sandbag. And then we'll be on to our fifth and final event of the day.
Check 1-2, check 1-2. Sorry, I don't know if you heard him. We're just in the middle of doing a quick changeover, and we'll be back shortly.
So now we're going back just to this.
Just finishing up with some of the warm-up for our athletes as we get ready for our final event, the keg over bar. Everybody getting stretched and loose. Looks like we're just about ready to get back underway for the keg over bar.
On the live stream, you can. No? Okay.
You sure you don't want to jump on? You got a face for radio.
Athletes ready.
We're underway.
Judges
for our
ready.
Keg over bar.
3, 2, 1, go!
As far as which athletes are where, I am unsure. I'm not going to lie to you.
Nice work. Everyone's got her.
I believe we have Lynn Sears on the far left. So in the middle lane, we've got Melissa Jones in the under 82 category.
The judges. Athletes ready.
On the far left, I believe we have
judges
Virginia.
Ready. 3, 2, 1, go!
Halfway through on this run.
Let's go.
Definitely see the fatigue setting in.
10 seconds. It's never, never. Let's go. Dig deep. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Time.
So now we'll have Jaslyn up on the far left, Tierney in the middle, and Serhi up on the far right side.
All right, athlete ready, judges ready. 3, 2, 1, go! Sergey Jazz off to a great start.
Really quick out of the gate over here for Sergey.
Keep that pace, Sergey. 30 seconds.
Left on this run. Everybody's trying to give it all.
This is your last event. Give it everything you got.
Last event of the day, so there's nothing to hold back.
You got one more. 5 seconds. Let's go. Come on. 3, 2, 1. Time.
So up next, we've got... Paula in the novice category. Should be Jessica in the middle.
All right, athletes ready. Judges
Ian?
Ready.
Oh,
Shannon. 3, 2, 1, go!
Shandy set another really blazing pace as he's been doing for a lot of the day. All three athletes putting together a really fast pace on all three implements. Shandy's completely clearing this bar as he's coming over the yoke. It's not even touching. Next up in our U57 and novice women, we got Sapphire Moody. Not sure what we've got coming up for our middle lane. And then we should have Ian in our close lane for the U90 men. We're going to have Kendra jumping into that middle lane. So Sapphire, Kendra, and then Ian on this close side.
All right, athletes ready. Judges ready. 3, 2, 1, go!
Ian setting a really quick pace on this. A lot of really quick reps out of this.
30 seconds.
Ian still maintaining that really fast pace. You can see the fatigue starting to set in a little bit, but still just very, very fast.
Come on, dig deep, dig deep. This is where it is. Lay it all down. 5 seconds. Let's go. 4, 3, 2, 1. Time.
Another really, really strong run by all three athletes. Next up on the far left in the U57 novice category, we've got Leanna Pollard. I'm not sure what we're going to end up with in the middle lane now. Oh, now we've got Muhammad coming in on the novice bar in the middle. And it should be Evan coming up on this very far right side, closest to the camera.
Judges ready.
Not sure if the audio is actually working or not for you guys. I hope it is. I know it's been very hit or miss.
Athletes ready. Judges ready. 3, 2, 1, go!
Yeah, this U90 category is... Sorry about that little disruption in audio. One of our photographers decided to take off with the cable. So we should have Jason in the middle. We've got Martin Blair coming out on the right side, I believe. Everybody wanting more Rupert action. He'll be up soon, I'm sure. Once again, we've got Martin Blair on the far right side, closest to the camera. Jason Rorick, and I believe it's Natalie Kent on the far side.
30 seconds.
Halfway through this run. Martin Blair here closest to the camera, really digging deep for that last rep.
3, 2, 1, time.
I think we're under our 105 athletes here.
Athletes ready. Judges ready. 3, 2, 1, go!
Oh, sorry. Now we've got Nicole on the far left side.
Seconds.
Solid push for the end of the day. You can see everybody's just exhausted. It's great to see, obviously, putting everything they have into it. So now on the far left side, we'll have Ashley. Where's our team? I apologize, I have lost access to my athlete sheet, so I'm going on names by memory here, and my memory is not that great.
Athletes ready. Judges ready. 3, 2, 1, go!
Ashley keeping up a very solid pace on that left side. Not sure if you guys can actually see her or not. I know there's a lot of people in a very small area for this one. So next up on the far side, we should have Mandy McCarthy. Justin Tebow here on the far right. I can't see who we've got in the middle. Mandy with a really good pace on that far side. Down to our last few seconds on this run. Again, yes, everybody's exhausted.
10 seconds.
Now on the far side, we should have Carolyn. I think we got Kevin Holt here on the far right. And not sure who's in the middle. Kevin really digging deep to get these last few reps in. 10 seconds left on this run. See if he's got one more in him.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1, time.
Quick weight change on that far lane with the assistance of Larson. I can see now why there's always two people at least trying to live stream broadcast this, because just being one person by yourself talking alone is sort of uncomfortable and a little awkward. 30 seconds left on this run. Time winding down for these last couple of reps.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1, time.
It's time for another round. Looks like, James Anderson coming up for the Masters heavyweight. We've got Jen on the far side. So should be we just saw Tammy on the far side. Now it'll be Jen in the left lane and James in the right. And again, bear with me, I can't remember the name of the guy in the middle. Looks like James is gonna call that a day. Again, with this strategic move being that he's competing basically twice all day long. Jen with a really good pace on that far side. The battle between the three athletes in our Masters division. Getting into the final seconds of this round.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1, time.
So now we should have Allison Martin coming up on the far end. I'm not sure who we'll have in the middle. Halfway through this round, all the athletes keeping up a pretty good pace.
Keep it up, keep it up!
Allison Martin with a big push to get that last rep out just in time. Todd over on the far left side.
I
believe that's Michael Clausen in the middle. Next up in the left lane, we should have Shea O'Brien. In the middle, we should have Isaiah, I believe. And then we have Ty on the right side.
Judges ready, 3, 2, 1, go!
Isaiah off to a really quick pace. Basically just stiff-legging that keg up to his lap. Ty has gotten himself into a really nice rhythm. Good foot position, not moving his feet in between reps. All three athletes, the really good pace, really steady through all of them.
15 seconds, go hard! Give it everything you've got! Don't stop, keep going! 4, 3, 2, 1, time!
So now I believe we'll have Jacqueline Klukach on the far left and Clifford Gray in the middle. And let's see if I can identify whoever's going to be on the right-hand side. For all the Rupert fans, your man is standing in the middle. Oh, and we get to see Ryan Vance put on an absolute display of strength and athleticism, taking away that empty yoke. He picked that from a 52-inch bar height, which, for a man his age, is impressive.
All right.
So Jackie on the left, Braden on the right. Now we're going to have a quick weight change. Now we're going to have Clifford Gray.
3, 2, 1, go!
Cliff off to a really good start, good pace. Good solid pace for Cliff here. Very mechanical. Again, no feet movement, just Every rep looks very, very similar. Always good to have the encouragement of everybody around.
We're doing a weight change now. We're going to have all the open men.
So now we're going to go to our open athletes, heavyweight men. Get Dave up first. You heard the man. It's athletes Dave Blake,
ready.
Live and on the air.
Judges ready? 3, 2, 1, go!
Dave, one of our first heavyweight athletes.
There it is, yeah.
Good first rep.
Folks, this is a 275-pound keg he's lifting here.
275-pound keg to a 52-inch bar. Even that little bit of extra encouragement, Dave just didn't quite have it in him for a second rep. I think our DJ has decided that the best thing to motivate people with this is slow songs about losing your girlfriend. We got Trevor coming up next in our heavyweight men. Trevor looks like he's ready to go. Again, that's a 270-pound keg. Trevor with really good pace going into this. Definitely giving it his all right up to that very last second. You can hear the crowd and the coaches and everybody getting in behind him. All the other athletes as well. Looks like Tyson will be our next competitor up.
Judges ready. 3, 2, 1, go!
Good rep for Tyson. Unfortunately, it blows his belt off. He's just going to continue on without it. Dig deep for this last one. Nice. You can tell, you can see the exhaustion on his face as he's walking away from that. Next up for the heavyweight men, we've got Rohan.
Ready. Judges ready.
Again, working with that injured thumb. See how that affects him coming up and over. Good first rep. Walking away with a smile on his face, that's always good to see. Smelling salts to get the mood set. Really close to that bar. Oh, just a little bit of a mishandle. Had that keg roll out of his lap. It's also why you see a lot of athletes use a grip shirt to make sure that that keg doesn't try and slide down on their abdomen. Digging deep, getting every rep he can out of this.
Come on.
Another great rep.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1, time.
Looks like we got Dan Hagen coming up as our next heavyweight. And from what I'm seeing on the side of the camera there, it looks like we're going to have a tiebreaker event in the Masters Women's event, or category, sorry. Looks like Jen and Allie might have a front hold for time. So we got Dan. Good first rep for Dan. Dan won the stone event, stone over bar, at the Noble Nerd in March. So very similar movement. Should be a very comfortable movement for Dan. Dan really clearing that bar quite well.
Come on, take deep. 15 seconds. Five, four, three, two, one, time.
Really good pace by Dan. You see as he's hunched over that yoke, he really left it all out there. So again, we got James Anderson coming up, this time as the heavyweight competitor, not the heavyweight masters. So keep in mind, he's already done this event once at a lower weight. So this will be his 10th event of the day. First rep by James, finding his rhythm. Crowd that's in here getting behind James, getting every rep out of him they can.
Let's go, James. 15 seconds. 10 seconds. One more. Let's go, James.
Let's see if he's got one more in him. Time might be a factor. That is, that's quite the feat.
No one ever took the claim of being
marinate a little. Solid pick up that first one, a little bit of a bobble out of the lap. Again, that keg being as shiny as it is slippery, without a grip shirt, it makes it very difficult to keep that up against your chest.
Let's go, Ryan. Let's go, dig deep, dig deep.
Ryan Hartman digging deep here. Calls it a day.
Tiebreaker?
Yeah, I thought two masters women are going to go up on time.
Fun.
Yeah.
Athletes and spectators, we have two more open athletes to go. As well, we have a tiebreaker right after that. We are going to also have an athlete photo outside, a quick cleanup, and then we're going to do awards. So please don't go anywhere. Stick around. And it's also your last chance to check out those amazing boots we got back there. Athlete ready? Judges
I will be
ready?
Right next.
3, 2, 1, go!
Riley Whiteknife, our second to last competitor in the heavyweight division. Definitely an advantage being the height that Riley is, basically waist high to get that keg over top. Riley with a fairly good pace here.
30 seconds, Riley. Let's go. Dig deep.
Again, his height is a great advantage for events like this. Full time for Riley Whiteknife. Another solid event for him.
All right, folks, our last open man.
So this will be the last athlete for our keg over bar, Big Ben Borger. Ben, another fairly tall athlete, so this should be a very comfortable height for him to load at.
All right, athlete ready, judges ready, 3, 2, 1, go! Come on, folks, let's cheer him on, he's the last open man of the day, come on! Let's go, Ben, everything he got!
A little bit of a bobble there, loaded into his lap, still a solid pace. Very mechanical, just very steady.
That's it, Ben. Keep it up. 30 seconds.
Halfway through this run, Ben's looking really solid. Calling it there as that's all he needed to win that event. So,
all right, folks, we're gonna do a tiebreaker. We're gonna go right away with this.
So now we're gonna do our tiebreaker event for our Masters women. It's gonna be a front hold for time, 25 pounds at arm's length. The weight has to stay between your chin and your forehead.
So for this last event, folks, this is a tiebreaker. It's going to be a front hold. They both have to keep their back and butt on the bar, and then they got to hold the weight in the incline. So for this, I want to hear some noise. I want to hear everyone yell at us, scream, and cheer them up. And this is for the win. We're going to give it everything we got, all right?
Thank you.
So Doug and Josh just going over the rules with both women to make sure that they understand it's going to be
timed based on when they where they start, when they stop. So it's not exactly a head-to-head, just because you don't want to give anybody an advantage of time of actually locking out.
Are you ready? Judges, are you ready? 3, 2, 1, go! That's it. You squeeze, you hold that up there.
This comes down to who wants it more.
Come on, folks, we gotta scrape.
It's an absolute grind.
They are giving it their all here. They didn't come here expecting to do a sixth event, but they are doing it right now. They're giving it their all. They're gonna hold it.
You can see them both starting to shake a little bit.
Everything you got! Yeah! Great job.
So Allie Martin takes that tie. The women are masters women.
We're going to do a quick cleanup, and then we're going to go. Oh, sorry. Athlete photo first. So can I please? Oh. Can I please have all the athletes to the bus? We're going to go in and get a photo. All athletes to the bus.
I want to thank everybody for tuning into this live stream. It's been an absolute pleasure. I hope you tune in next time.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, that's it for the stream here today. We're going to be shutting it down here. In the next about half an hour to an hour or so, the ASA scoreboard will be released again. You'll be able to see what your friends and family have produced. And, yeah, I'm sure you'll hear from them, too, with text messages and whatnot. But we're going to shut down the stream. It's been a little bit of a long run here. I had to go onto the score table for the last hour here, but thank you everybody for tuning in. I know we had a couple technical difficulties with network connections at the beginning, and then at event number three, at the end of number three into number four, we had to recreate a new link for the stream. But thank you once again, and we will chat to you guys soon. Thanks again.